They've also said that they've seen some slowdown in the bath and kitchen business this quarter. So to take you through those numbers, bath fittings business sales declined by 11%, 10.9% on a year-on-year basis, and the kitchen business sales decreased by 7.1%.
Both those as well is, you know, are misses, because a 10%, 11% decline in bath fittings business, which the company plans to triple in over the, you know, medium to long term, would reek of some sort of consumer weakness in terms of demand. The kitchen business as well declining by about 7%. But all of this, you know, ties in with what the company plans to do in the longer term. That is point number one. And in the extreme near term, you have the competition, you know, overhang looming on Asian Paints itself. We do have Grasim, which is coming about, and then we had Asian Paints announce almost 9,000 crore capex as well, 2,000 crores in the last few weeks when we got the announcement of a water-based plant, and 7,000 crores for the back-end unit that the company, backward integration that they are doing. So the stock has recovered from the lows, though, because it was weak over the last few trading sessions, as was the entire FMCG pack. Will be, you know, let's get in Naveen Kulkarni. Naveen, the reported numbers are extremely weak as compared to what the street was anticipating. But do you think that the street is looking ahead and perhaps taking some cues from the fact that December was good, and maybe that may continue going forward?
Yeah, so if we look at the numbers per se, so this was expected to be a weak quarter, to be very honest, because our channel checks indicated that the volumes have been very, very sluggish. And most likely, whatever growth would have happened, that would have happened on the low-margin products. So that is one thing which was coming through. And the market also, I believe, was building for this, because the stock has not done much over the last 3 to 4 months compared to even the other FMCG companies. So from that perspective, these kind of numbers were expected. However, I will say that the margin profile looks probably a little better than what we were expecting, so that is encouraging. So from here on, if December was strong and this quarter improves, I think the stock can probably do well from the current levels.
Right. You know, one thing that was surprising this time around is that while the volumes are flat, overall sales also have increased by just about 1% odd on a standalone basis, 1.7% on a consolidated basis. And this is a time when we're speaking about the company having taken price hikes to the tune of almost 20% over the last 15 months or so. Some amount of price realization growth should have come about, right? What explains this weakness? I mean, are people really looking at only the lower end of products? And if yes, then it's not even showing in the volumes. I'm confounded by that.
Yeah, so essentially, as I was saying, so the volume mix is more to do with low-end products, which is like putty and others. I think that is where the contribution has been higher, and that's why the realization growth looks a tad slower. But in the overall context, the EBITDA margins are still quite okay, right? So that is, I think, one thing they have managed to do well. So, but I think going ahead, we have to see how the volume mix changes. I think this quarter clearly, post the management conference call, we might get more details. But I think it's very, very clear that the products like putty and all have contributed much, much more.
All right. The question is, what do you do with the stock now? I mean, you said that if things look good from here, it can be a buy right now. But you do have a lot of overhangs with regards to competition going ahead, not particularly cheap in terms of valuations as well. And that initial smidge of a recovery that we had seen has been sold into. Now the stock is virtually at the low point of trade. What do you do? It's about 18% off its all-time highs, but still not particularly cheap. Your thoughts?
Yes, sir. A franchise like Asian Paints, we will be very, very lucky to get it cheap. And history has suggested that whenever things look very, very stressful from those levels, the stock has managed to bounce back quite well. Whether it happens in a similar manner this time or not, something remains to be seen. But I would say that considering the way the market is shaping up and lack of opportunities in so many sectors, Asian Paints is probably not a bad bet as an allocation theme, right? So I think people might still allocate to Asian Paints. I don't see a huge downside. Upside is something that we can talk about, as in whether it's 15% or 20% or 10%. But probably I don't see much of downside, and it might be a still good allocation bet from 2023 perspective.
All right. Naveen, thank you so much for joining in. So that basically is the sum and substance of Asian Paints. It's a top-down miss as far as the revenues, volumes are concerned. EBITDA, I mean, there is an improvement, but that was something that the street was anticipating because of the cool-off that we've seen in the raw material prices. This time around, more than the margins is the demand, which is a problem. So let's see whether that sustains. The spike that we saw in December sustains into the next quarter or not. And until that, we get any sort of comfort from the management on that, the stock may perhaps languish.
And ultimately, people care about the EPS, right? Yeah. The profits itself are missed. So despite the margins coming in higher than estimates, the quantum of miss on the top line was so much that the profits have come in lower. So there is no case for, you know, any sort of EPS to move up because of the margin beat, right? That's not flowing through into the bottom line.
That's not flowing through. My sense is that post the conference call, I wouldn't be surprised if we do actually see a few EPS cuts and downgrades as well coming in on account of the demand part. Because earlier, whatever downgrades happened were on account of margins, and now if the top line fails to exceed the street, then maybe we can see some problems with regards to any returns coming here. But then again, all of this hinges on what the management has to say about demand sustaining going forward or not.
First 19 days of January, let's see what the company has to say, whether that double-digit demand continues.
Okay, so that is, of course, an important thing to track, right? The management commentary coming in from Asian Paints. Right now, the stock is at the day's low. We will slip into a short break now and get you more on the markets and stock-specific action on the other side. Stay tuned.